What's up, Gear Mortals? Trey Xavier here. Today I am just outside of Gdansk, also known as Danzig, Poland, at the Skurvison factory, and we're gonna take a look at the crazy beautiful custom guitars that they are building right here. Check it out.
Hello everyone, welcome at Skurvison Guitars Company. Today we're going to show you how the factory works and tour you through the whole workshop. And I hope you will like it. This is actually where the whole process begins. This is Jarek's office, where he creates all the CAD/CAM drawings. This is where all of the designs are made. He's currently working on some really custom inlays, custom neck shapes, weird variations that needs more attention from him. This is the source of every single Skurvison that was ever created. This is the main CNC for fretboards and necks. We do the slots with the CNC, the initial shape, the back of the neck. All the heavy stuff is made with this one. The neck truss, longer scales, most of the bodies. So yeah, we have to combine work from these two machines, and then everything that leaves CNC goes to those guys on the other side. Those are all clamps for neck truss for the milling here. There's a lot of them because they need to fit really tight. We use some custom-made contraptions built especially for a single purpose. Like, for example, this one is built just for gluing the bodies. This one's built just for gluing the necks. We have some prototypes hidden here and there, but those are the two main ones in use right now. This is like the library that you can choose from instantly. If you just come here, you can look at the bodies and we can help you choose from the stuff that we've got here. We have some nice black limba pieces right here, waiting to be, you know, become a guitar one day. There's not much here because we only take them out from the magazine if we think that they are already, you know, ready for some further work. You can actually see that some of these are already prepared for certain builds. For example, if we use chambering, this is actually quite cool design. This little egg is placed between the pickups and gives a nice spark to the tone. We don't have no idea how it works, but it works. After a lot of experimenting, this one was actually the coolest idea. This is a Soul model, so it has a Porfero inlaid piece into the ash. It will be a 4AP one day.
We also have some special ones
saved if you want really unusual patterns, stuff like that. These are ready. Those are mostly parts for the necks. It looks like a mess, but the man who's responsible for gluing the necks, I think he kind of finds himself in this organized chaos. So just by looking at those necks on a finished product, you can see that somehow he manages to find his way. Those are freshly glued bodies for the next batch with the sealed ends. So to save them from cracking. Some new tops from the new batch that we recently have. I think this is the stuff that we are mostly associated with, the burls. We have some nice spots right here. If you want to go really crazy with this stuff. The landscapes are always cool, especially with Zuricoto becoming more and more popular. Basically, the thickness of the tops never go less than 5 or 6 millimeters, but for some builds, especially with carved tops, we need at least 16 millimeters. Here we glue the necks. You can see the blanks. So those are made with Ovanco, 5 pieces with Bubinga layers and a maple middle part. This is where the blanks go to when they're ready. To, you know, have some time, reduce some of the internal strengths that are kept in the wood. Some of them are just blanks, straight out of CNC. Some of them have already carved backs, but those, most of them go for gluing the fretboard. This is actually a really important place. Here we glue all the bindings on the necks. This is also the place where you get the frets. Again, a mess, but it's actually really organized mess. All the radiuses are made by hand, actually. We don't use CNC for the radius itself. It's made by hand with just this machine. Same guy that does the, that presses the frets is also sculpting the surface of the fretboard. The most important part is right here. So these two guys are working with the wood straight away from the CNC. This is what actually makes a guitar, because if you compare stuff that goes straight from the machine to the effect that they achieve, you can see that CNC is not making guitars, it's just a helpful tool. And you need a lot of work to come from this to actual guitar. And this is your guitar. You can see how much work was put between the CNC and the final product, what will come to spraying booth later. I think you will also try the right arm cut, because it's quite unusual with this model. It's a little bit deeper. You've got some swamp ash sticking out.
I waited and I waited and I waited. And after a while I was like, fuck it, I'm going to Poland. I need my guitar, I need to see it. This is the update. Everybody's asking for an update. Here it is. Wow, it's really light. That is a piece of wood right there. When it's finally done, the color that it's gonna be, I think it's gonna look like a swimming pool or an ocean, and I'm gonna wanna dive into it. Love a neck through guitar. This is a infinity piece, a 1,000-piece neck, I think. Look at that, they spelled my name right and everything. They fucked up the number, but that's okay. Obviously, I can't tell you how it plays because it doesn't have any of the important stuff that makes a guitar make sound, like strings. But this is so cool that I was, you know, just happened to be bumming around Europe, and I was like, hey, I'll go to Poland and hang out with some Polish guitar builders. And that's pretty rare. If you order a custom guitar, it's pretty unlikely that you will get to go to the place where it's made and see it in the process, you know, getting somewhere. Like, I've only done that once before, and that was at the Kiesel factory, which is reasonably close to me. You know, I'm not gonna get on a plane and fly to Poland every time I wanna see how far the guitar has come. Luckily, they've been sending me pictures, so I knew what to expect when I got here. So this is really fun. This is my first time in Poland ever. And I'm just gonna sit down real quick, and I'm just gonna hold it close.
So yeah, CNC does the initial job of cutting the cavities, milling the excessive material, but all the finishing, curves, lines, it's all made by hand here. So yeah, every single one of them is really an individual product that needs individual care. So, and they're not actually, you know, mass produced stuff, so they vary. Guitar to guitar, they will never be exactly the same. But I think that's part of this, you know, particular segment, right? If you go with handmade, even though we use tools like CNC to help us do this, you will achieve a custom handmade guitar. But I will totally agree that going just with the hand make, with the workshop stuff like that, you don't really want this. You want to have as much technology backing you, helping you to create consistent product. And this is like the backup place for when we want to, you know, add something to what the main spraying booth is doing. This is the stuff that Mikołaj, who is sanding the bodies, shaping the necks, shaping the bodies, he's also spraying some guitars from time to time. So this is his free will, actually. He's improvising this stuff. Here we have a nice little stock shoggy in the middle of production. I think we have some stuff that's completely new right now already for this. This is actually the new version of a Mirage. So you have the sculpted armrest, you have the inlaid, I don't know even how to call it. Is it still a pickguard if you can't remove it? The new stuff with the Mirage is that now we will do it with the truss rod correction from the side of the pickup instead of our usual Raptor way with the regulation from the stocks, headstock side. With this one, we wanted to go more with the classic vibe, so the headstock won't be angled. It will be like more like a Fender style with the parallel headstock. With the new Mirage, you have the truss rod here and the headstock veneer bends to the shape and the angle is created. You've got tons of fanned threads, straight scales, different types of bridges, EverTuned here, hip shots here, the Schaller harness here. So yeah, every single one of them is different and needs this individual approach to them. Some of the stuff that is already done, finished with the final coats, that's redwood, I think, was stained with a little bit of secret mixture. This is like the second library with more stuff that is roughly, you know, made to shape. Some of these bodies are actually ready to go for the spraying booth. Lots of blank necks, lots of blank bodies. Yeah, this is the stuff that, you know, has to wait for the customers because that's our priority the whole time. And you can also see some crazy stuff actually right here, like a telly with the PRS tremolo, and the actual inlaid pickguard isn't even really inlaid, it's just the shape of the pickguard made with the mother of pearl. Not really unusual, but we're kind of happy with this design since with this thick tops, we can achieve some really nice deep shapes, carves that help this one be really ergonomic, but still give this quite dynamic and aggressive look. This one's actually really unusual combination for us because that's a really heavy body. It's really stiff and rigid because of the layer glued between those, between the top and the body. African mahogany with redwood top and maple layer between them. Most of our guitars are built with a little bit different philosophy with the swamp ash bodies. Those are like 70% of what we do are ash bodies with the burl tops combined with rigid heavy necks. A little bit different combination that gives you different results, but sometimes you just want to experiment and try something new to see what could happen. We have some really, really old stuff here from experimenting. This is like a already discounted model, Chiroptera, but this is actually a thick, full ebony top with African mahogany in the back. Everything that has been discounted and we'll never see.
Oh, do you mean discontinued?
Yeah, discontinued, yeah. Here you can see some neck through side panels ready for clamping with the neck, because with the neck through, this is like the final step after doing all you have to do with the neck, after, you know, shaping the neck initially, shaping the fretboard surface, giving the radius, and, you know, pushing the frets in. This is like the final step, so we have them ready for the all those builds that are in progress right there. Lots of experimenting, like this one, for example. I can't really take him out because I think that I will drop some stuff above, but this is like 9 pieces neck, something really rigid, really stiff. So we're looking at some really nice burl with graphite burst that is mid spraying. So it has been stained. It has some, you know, coats already on. I think it's ready for some finishing touches before we will go with the satin finish, I think, on this one. Yeah, you can see how with every single layer it gets deeper and more three-dimensional. This is actually a stock model. There's been some experimenting with the finish with this one. I think fades are the last hit, so we should follow it, right? Again, burl with some nice flame. And you can see that after some sanding between the coats, you lose some of the deep looks and the vivid of the color, but once you apply the finishing coats, you will bring that back even more than before. Yeah, now it slowly becomes a standard that we recess all these string furrows. This is actually something new that we are working on. Lots of people wanted to see some cheaper Raptors around. So we decided to go with the rendition of a Raptor that has 3 pieces bodies. Mostly now ash tops on them. And we're just experimenting with the finishes, make it a little bit more affordable, yet still in Skervison vibes. So yeah, we just finished the first one from this raw batch. They sound pretty decent, to be honest. I can't really hear the difference between these and the regular Raptors. But yeah, of course, that's just three pieces body, no top, just the binding here to cover that up. I think you will see more of these soon on the market. Yeah, this is the example of guitar that is a couple years old, but we are more than happy to get them back, refinish them, make them great once more. So yeah, this one's actually like 2 or 3 years old. It will get refinished with a new neck. That's basically it. All you have to do is hit us up and we will see what we can do. This is the assembly area where all the finished guitars go. Here they are, straight from the spraying booths, waiting for the assembly. As you can see, the line is pretty long right now. Here you can see some of them partially finished with the at the fretwork stage. At these four tables, we bring them to life. Those two are in the middle of the fretwork. So here you can see the leveling and here you can see them after crowning. This is the most important part here in the assembly because we really take care about this particular thing. We sandpaper them to 1000 grit. Then we shape them with three different kinds of files. And then we polish them up to 20,000. Here you can see the final stage with slotting the ABM saddles to fit the string gauges. The electronics are all already made. I can show you the inside. Yeah, lots of tape. This is the most important thing at a guitar factory is tape. So yeah, it's all copper shielded, but it's what's makes it different is that it's actually soldered together. The ground actually is connected to the shielding. So once you close it, you create a Faraday's cage to protect it from the external sources of noise and stuff like that. So yeah, people often see these and ask why there's no ground connected to the volume knob or stuff like that. There's always an explanation for what's happening right here. We just have a kind like different approach to electronics here. And it all comes from the man himself, Vico, who created the world domination mode and is responsible for how those cavities look right now. You can't really tell, but we only use stainless steel screws to hold this together. This particular neck is, I think it's higher neck with maple fillets and some ebony to it, and really simplistic inlay. There is always this second level of quality control on every single step that we do. So even though somebody decided that he can push the guitar further away, the next person in the line checks after him. After guy right here checks all the stuff, screws the guitar together, and he passes it to me or Vikel for fretwork and mounting the actual hardware. He checks it, we check it later, and there's this final stage right here with the strings and stuff like that, and final quality check. So it's not just single process, it's actually laid down throughout the whole process of creating this one. Here's where we get the cavity covers. Every single one of them is shaped by hand and fits this particular guitar. Every single one of them is shaped especially for this single body. That's handmade, so. Yeah, this is the setup stage. Here you can see
the stuff that is already finished.
So this is the final product with all the plates, dampeners and stuff. You can see the frets after some heavy polishing. And as usual, this is probably the most representative guitar that I can show you with the reverse Blue Boost ash body with barrel top, Venga Bubinga neck, five pieces, Hipshot open gear tuners. This one's got the Schaller Hannes bridge. We recessed them for this particular height relation between the body and the neck. Here's something cool. That's a 7-string fender press Raptor with the Viper headstock, but also it has the ETS piezo system combined with the Richter preamp. So yeah, it has two outs. One is for piezo only, and one is for the mix. Actually, can get a really nice acoustic tone out of this. Even though it still looks like a Skurveson, it can be quite different in approach.
And now for something completely different.
Here's this one that has some really nice red and graphite staining on it. It has the wooden bobbins made with the Birdeye maple, stained red and black. This is actually the first one that we've made with the Hipshot single tuners, I mean solo tuners. Also on demand, the sole feature here, made with the rosewood in the Limba body. And again, Wenger Bubinger neck. This is the first example of the Velociraptor series that will come really soon. Those are cheaper version of the Raptor, but they have all the features they need to be Skurveson. Because again, stainless steel frets, taken care same way that we do in our high-end models. High quality hardware, Hipshot bridge, shallow tuners in this one, swamp ash body with three pieces maple neck. Sounds really nice. Thanks for watching, hope you liked it. For further information, check our website, skurveson.eu, and our media, like Instagram, Facebook. Cheers.